Hello everyone, I am Huawei Instructor Lee Shuan. In the last class, we discussed VRP technical knowledge and the upgrade methods for AC and AP devices. In this class, we will talk about knowledge related to WLAN security. WLAN is now a widely used access method in public places. As more and more people use WLAN for access, our security requirements for WLAN will also increase. So, in this class, I will explain some knowledge about WLAN access security, data security, and configuration security. Now, let's take a look together. After completing this class, you will know what security threats WLAN faces and what security defense mechanisms we have to address these threats. Of course, I will also list some commonly used access authentication methods, which are quite practical. In our daily work, we can use different authentication methods to distinguish between secure and insecure networks. So, this lesson is divided into five sections: security threats and defenses, access security, data security, WLAN network usage control, and security configuration. I will also show you in detail how to configure security in the experiment. First, let's take a look at WLAN security threats and defenses. As we can see in this topology, we have two APs. These two APs are both completely open. So, what threats will we encounter? With Wi-Fi without authentication, in this case, an attacker can freely connect to our wireless network. After connecting to our wireless network, they will have the ability to attack all the network devices and users. So, if you encounter an unauthenticated Wi-Fi, everyone must be cautious. The second layer of security threat is wireless data encryption. What does this mean? It means that during our online activities, our device, i.e., our STA, our terminal, communicates with our AP. During communication, if our data is not encrypted, other devices can also receive the electromagnetic waves we transmit, right? If it's not encrypted, other devices will know what content our transmitted information contains. Our privacy may be unintentionally intercepted. The third layer is boundary threats. Here we see an illegal AP, which broadcasts the same SSID. For example, the SSIDs of AP1 and AP2 are both Huawei. These two APs are legitimate, but there is an illegal AP here, which also uses the Huawei SSID. Users may unknowingly connect to this illegal AP. In such cases, user data will be directly sent to this illegal AP. The hacker doesn't even need to perform air interface packet capture. Users will voluntarily send their data over. These are some common types of threats. If the network is not authenticated, it can be attacked. If data is not encrypted, it is easy to be intercepted. Others can decipher what you are transmitting. Another issue is unauthorized APs, directly connecting to an unauthorized AP. All your transmitted data can be intercepted. In response to these threats we discussed, we now have specific security measures in place. The first one is what's called secure authentication. You may have noticed this. When we go to public places, we find many Wi-Fi networks. But most of them require a password, ensuring that not just any device can access our network. Regarding secure authentication, we can also opt for mutual authentication. Users can authenticate the server, and the server can authenticate users. In this case, we can verify whether the AP is unauthorized. Similarly, a legitimate AP can also determine if a user is unauthorized. This is what we call mutual authentication. This is the most common method. The second one, data encryption and integrity. This means our data should be encrypted during transmission. If it is not encrypted, others can intercept and know our information. Then, integrity is ensured by using hash, along with MICs and CRC. This way, when our server receives the data, it can determine if the data has been tampered with. This function ensures data integrity. The third one is so-called perimeter security. In this lesson, we won't cover perimeter security in detail, just an overview will suffice. Perimeter security includes wireless intrusion detection systems, WIDS, and wireless intrusion prevention systems, WIPS, commonly referred to as WIDS and WIPS. In this session, we will focus mainly on secure authentication and data encryption and integrity. That concludes this session. This covers the content for lesson 5. That is all for this lesson.